Hello everyone, I'm back with another video which is a sort of add-on to my previous one. In that video we discussed how the electric field due to circular wire and straight wire are equal. But first thing is first, I must answer you the question which I asked in the end of that video. So if you don't remember it, please pause and read it again. So I've taken this as a triangular wire ABC having a charge density lambda all over it, and I have drawn a in circle of this triangular wire. Now we already know that the electric field due to a straight wire and the circular wire at the center of that circular wire will be equal. So due to wire AB, the field due to wire AB must be identical to the field due to wire PQ. And this PQ wire is a circular arc. Similarly, field due to BC must be equal to the field due to QR. And finally, field due to wire AC will be equal to field due to this circular wire PR. So, this triangle will be making fields which are identical to these arcs, arc PQ, QR and RP. And collectively, they make a ring. And we have already discussed this, that the charge density must be equal to lambda. And due to symmetry, I can say that the field at the center of this ring must be zero. Okay guys, for the last part, we want to see whether the same concept which we use for the straight wires can be extended over to a two-dimensional sheet of charge. Whether or not this plain sheet of charge will give me the same electric field as some type of a curved surface. So here we go. Okay guys, as you see that this is a infinite sheet of charge. Consider it to be an infinite sheet of charge, and we already know that the electric field due to this infinite sheet of charge at point P is given by sigma by 2 epsilon naught. I want to know whether or not I can form some type of a curved surface same as before, where we proved that the field due to a straight wire is identical to a curved wire. In this case also, can we form some type of a curved surface which will give me the same electric field at point P as this sheet of charge? So I have two options actually. First one is, I can take a hemispherical surface, which is centered at P and whose radius is from P to this particular point, let's call it O. There is a second option in which what we can do, that we can take a semi-cylindrical surface. Now, the orientation would be such that the axis of that cylinder will be passing through P and it will be parallel to the surface. The radius obviously of that semi-cylinder will be again OP. Now, I want you to imagine whether or not we can extend that same concept onto these two surfaces. Please pause the video and think over it. Okay, so let me just show you quickly that this particular concept cannot be extended to two dimensions. There cannot be any way in which you can divide this sheet into small sections. Each section can be considered as a infinite wires, such that they all form some sort of circular wires and end up being a known curved surface. And there is one more proof, that we know that the electric field at the center of a hemispherical charged surface is E is equal to sigma by 4 epsilon naught. And this is a little bit a lesser known result, that The field at the point on an axis of the infinitely large, infinitely long semi-cylinder is sigma by pi epsilon naught. So the results also contradicts, and we can say that this concept cannot be extended to two dimensions. Thank you. Thank you for watching.